will know. The more that you learn, the more places you will go. So with spatial excitement and eagerness to learn, I am pleased to welcome Ms. Shweta Sharma on behalf of the entire team of A2 Aviation Private Limited and Asiatic International Business Academy. It is an honor for me to introduce our special guest of the day in the International Webinar 2020. Ms. Shweta Sharma believes that people have the capacity to grow and to become better individuals and professionals through constant learning. This belief brought her in people development. She is a specialist in learning and development in BirlaSoft. She has more than 8 years of working experience. She has worked in various areas like performance management, recruitment and selection, training and development, payroll system, talent management, and so on. So here we have a gigantic opportunity to learn from Ms. Shweta Sharma. So now Ms. Shweta, is all over to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your warm introduction, and I'm really happy to have all of you here, and thank you so much for having me here on this platform. So first of all, thank you so much, Shekhar. Thank you so much, Ricky, for giving me this opportunity, and thank you so much to Aircrew Aviation Private Limited for giving us this platform. So before I begin, I just want to confirm if I'm audible and all of you are able to hear me loud and clear.
Yeah, I can hear you, but your video is off.
Okay, though I can see myself on the screen. But is it same for everyone?
I can see your screen, but your video is off. Cannot see your face.
Okay. All right, so I think I'll start appearing on the screen because I can see myself here. So I think it'll take a couple of minutes and we'll be ready with it. So shall we begin?
Yeah, definitely.
Sure. So today's session is, all about the life from campus to corporate, what kind of changes we go through, how, we need to deal with certain things when we are actually in a corporate atmosphere, what happens in the corporate, what happened, in the campus, and how do we prepare ourselves is very, very important. So that is what I'm going to cover in today's session. I will also, talk about how you prepare yourself and, what kind of preparations are required once you are ready to the corporate environment from the campus, because things will be definitely changed in a corporate environment as we compare it to the campus environment. So on this note, I would, like to begin with the session. All right, I'm facing some challenge and I'm not able to change the slide. Can I share the rights with you, and can somebody control it remotely?
You can share over the WhatsApp.
Sure.
Now the same thing.
Yeah. Okay.
Either you have to go to.
Let me just reshare it.
Yeah. Yeah, we can see your screen.
Okay, sure. Yes, it works now. So before I begin, I would request everyone to please keep yourself on mute. And I would also request that let's make it an interactive session. So whenever you have any kind of questions, feel free to unmute yourself and you can raise your questions. Yes, and a lot of people are still waiting in the lobby, so I'm just admitting them. All right. Thank you once again for joining in. And let's begin with it. Okay, again, the same issue is coming. So a little bit about me. I'm Shweta Sharma. As Ricky already mentioned, I'm part of learning and development team. I'm passed out from Exilari Jamshedpur. It's been 11 years I'm into this industry. Now I'm part of IT industry, though I have experience in media, education, and BPO industry as well. So I work with HCL in their BServe unit. And apart from this, I have a journey from journalist to generalist profile. So generalists who are not from the HR field, it will be difficult for them to understand. So generalist is a person who has a lot of competencies in the HR area. That is called generalist. And journalist, people who are from the reporting background, which is always there in front of you. So that is what journalism is. So I am actually from the journalistic background, and then I end up doing HR and the learning. I have worked with HCL as a HR business partner, and now I'm associated with Birlasoft as a learning partner. So if you really want to know more about me, and if you really want to share your views with me, please feel free to connect through my LinkedIn profile, which I have shared here, and I'll be happy to connect with all of you. So basically, what's in it for you in today's session? So we are going to talk about the corporate tools, which I'll be sharing with you basis on my experience, basis on some of the research which has happened in this area. Also, we will talk about the personal branding, which is becoming very, very important in today's scenario, where you actually have to compete with a lot of people when you talk about a corporate environment, and then how you handle a difficult situation. So I call it a personal risk management framework. So how do you manage certain kind of risk? And then we will close this session with a note as to from where you actually have to begin. So once you're beginning with your journey, you can keep me posted, and that becomes my ROI, return on the investment, as to how you are moving. That is how I'm going to calculate my overall effort plus the learning journey which you'll start post this session. So let's do a quick comparison between campus and corporate. So when this name campus, whenever I hear this name campus, one thing which comes into my mind, and I'm hoping that it comes into your mind as well, is all about the freedom, the environment which you get in campus. Unfortunately, you can never get that kind of environment in the corporate. So one, definitely when we talk about campus, learning is something which comes into the picture, and foundation building. We learn a lot of things in the campus. There is a lot of freedom. There are a lot of friends on which you can rely. There are evaluations, but evaluations are decided in the form of examinations. And then there is just 25% of hands-on through which you try a lot of things. And then, of course, the most important thing, whatever you do doesn't matter, because you are not going to affect others. You have your friends, you will get into a fight with them, and then next day everything will be settled, there will be no problem at all. However, if I really compare it to the corporate environment, application is very, very important. So whatever you have learned in the campus environment, this is the time for you to apply those learnings, build your career, responsibility, and it's all about timeline. So what thing you are taking and by when you'll be able to deliver. This is what we do in the corporate. And then there are a lot of daily evaluations. There are a lot of performance reviews on which, somebody will measure you, measure your capability, measure, what exactly you are doing on daily basis. And it is 100% practical. Because it is 100% practical, so you can imagine the mistakes sometimes we commit while performing certain kind of roles and responsibilities. And then most important thing here, everything is interlinked, let me tell you, because in campus you say anything about anyone, it will not reach to that person. But here in corporate environment, you say anything, it will reach directly where it's not supposed to be reached. So that is how it is. So there's a huge difference in campus to corporate environment. And let's understand what kind of differences are there. Let's understand how can we prepare ourselves. See, we can just do only one thing, that is preparation. If the preparation is good, everything goes fine with us. But if we are not prepared and suddenly we are reaching to a corporate environment, then you will just, you know, start with a lot of question marks. And by the time you're getting answer to those question marks, I think you will land up in certain situation where there is no coming back, you know. So let's move forward with this. So I'm going to share some professional toolkits with you, and these toolkits are designed by me. These toolkits are something which is the result of my deep thought process, and of course with the help of my mentors I have designed this complete toolkit for all of you. I have tried to put in a lot of scenarios which you can come across once you're reaching to the campus, to corporate environment, so this transition becomes easy for you if you are able to remember these tools, if you are able to apply some of these learnings in your routine life. So the first step is definitely to start planning. Planning is a very, very important step. So how do you plan your first impression? I'm not sure, if all of us thought about it. In fact, if I really have to talk about myself, I'm not able to recall any moment where I actually thought when I was in campus that how I have to plan my first impression in my organization, right? I never thought about it. And because of that, there are a lot of bad, good experiences which I carry with myself, and I'm going to share all of that with you. So I think, the first step is today. So in the campus environment right now, you think how you are going to carry an impression for your new organization. What kind of things you really want to carry? What kind of impressions you really want to build on your new organization? So first step is to understand industry. No matter what industry you are going to, so if you are from an aviation industry, and I'm just assuming that there are a lot of participants, so I'm assuming they are from different industries as well. Some of them are from IT industry, some of them are from some other industry. So it is very important for you to understand about the industry, how it works, and let me tell you, it's not a rocket science. Everything is available on internet. Everything is available through different platforms, learning platforms, and I'll talk about it. I will share those tips also with you. So once you are able to understand about the industry, let me tell you, nobody in your organization can make you realize that you are a fresher and you cannot do this. Because you have industry knowledge, people will listen to you with more respect. People will give you a space to share your views, to talk about your thought process. So that is how you make your first impression. That is how you make first place for yourself in your new organization. Learn about technology. That is very, very important. So there are a lot of technology around us. If we talk about ML, if we talk about artificial intelligence, which is actually Alexa, there are a lot of things around you. Just try understand those technologies which belongs to your industry, which belongs to your leaders, to your daily life. You should learn about them so that once you are reaching to a corporate environment and somebody is talking to you, you'll be able to relate their thought process with whatever you know. And you can also bring a new perspective while connecting with all of them. And just try add, try to add some more power. More power means, you learn about some of the tools like Excel, PowerPoint presentation, which you're able to see on the screen. So these kind of things will, help you to stand out from the crowd, So just imagine a fresher is coming into a corporate and a fresher with some kind of training is coming into a corporate. Who will be the first choice of a leader? Of course, a person who knows the basics, who knows about the industry, who knows about the technology. So that is what we have to achieve through these things. Communication skills, let me tell you, always work cherry on the cake, It is like that. So if you have good communication skills, if you don't have good communication skills, you can build that up, It's not a rocket science. It's very easy. There are a lot of training programs available now free on the internet. So if you have good communication skills, try build up written verbal communication skills so that you can create an impact. See, it is so if you know about industry, it is easy, to come out from any situation, any difficult situation, or to make a place for yourself into a particular forum. But what if you know about the industry, but you don't know how to communicate? How are you going to talk about whatever you know? So it goes hand in hand. So industry knowledge, communication skills, technology, and of course, you know, keep on adding more power to yourself. Power dressing, I don't think I really have to talk about it, since all of you, most of you are from the aviation industry. You guys know better than all of us that, you know, how to dress up, what is power dressing, and how it help you to create, a space for yourself. What people think about you, what kind of, you know, dress you wear, how you take that conscious decision about your dressing when you are going to office. That is something which is very, very important. You know, sometimes people have a lot of knowledge. They have good communication skills, everything is there, but you know, they just don't get through certain things because of the power dressing approach. So that is also which is becoming very, very important in the corporate area. Then you socialize, guys. You know, this is for all of you who are right now in campus and will be moving to corporate. Let me tell you, your best friend is not Facebook, it's definitely LinkedIn, because LinkedIn will definitely, you know, give you maybe not good jobs sometime, yes, it will definitely give you the knowledge, new perspective, what is happening in the industry, how we are going, where we are going, who can become my mentor. So those kind of informations you can definitely take out from the LinkedIn. Follow few people who lead your industry and understand their perspective through their post, whatever they are posting. You also post, so these are the things which will help you to get socialized in your own industry. And let me tell you, you will understand a lot of new things through this exercise. Then, of course, internship, corporate industry visits play a very, very important role. So whenever you are getting chance to visit to any corporate industry, or if you're getting a chance to do the internship, do not miss that. That is very, very important step for you if you really want to, move, grow in your professional career. So go for it. Look how industries work, how corporate, what is the corporate environment? How do they work? So this understanding will definitely prepare you for, future. And develop the habit of reading business magazine and newspapers. That will also bring a lot of perspective. I can guarantee that, that will bring a different thought process, out-of-box thinking. Once you will connect with somebody, you'll be able to bring all those things which you have maybe gone through in a magazine, in a newspaper, and that builds, that becomes a first foundation for your first impression, and this is how you can move forward in your corporate life. On this note, let's move to the tool number two. So what happens? So once, you are ready, you are in the transition of hiring, and then you are hired, and, there are certain things which you have to do before hiring, and that is what I'm going to cover in tool two. So always reach at least 30 to 40 minutes before. And this is very, very basic thing. You must be thinking that why we are talking about this, 30, 40 minutes is a normal time. And I always follow that, but why you follow that is very important to understand. So see, once you are reaching, for an interview, or maybe if you're reaching to meet someone, if you're reaching 30 to 40 minutes early, that for 30 to 40 minutes will give you a perspective, will give you an opportunity to understand about the culture. So there are different type of corporate culture. Few are open and few are closed. So at least you can have a glance of that open culture, how people are coming, what time they are coming in, what kind of dressing sense they have, this company deals in what kind of areas. You can connect, you can understand the environment, you can understand the surroundings. And once you are comfortable, I think 30, 40 minutes are absolutely fine for a person to get comfortable with any atmosphere. And especially when you are going for an interview, you feel a lot of nervousness, and this 30, 40 minutes will help you to adjust with that nervousness, So always reach 30, 40 minutes early, understand the venue, understand certain things, how this organization work, how it looks like overall, what kind of people are there, that will also give you a lot of perspective. And then once you are through with this, let me tell you, you will feel very, very confident, for your next step, which will be an interview, formal interview with your leader or maybe your recruiter. And do your homework. Please do not go without homework. So if you are going for a particular position, you please research about industry, trends, changes, and how many changes are there in the last few months. What is happening in that industry? Because that will give you a power again to lead the discussion, to lead the conversation which you will be having with your recruiter, with your leader, and the person who will be who will take the final decision to select you. So research about industry trends, changes will give you a platform to talk about the challenges they must be facing and how can you resolve it, how can you become an asset to an organization. And definitely read about company profiles. So of course, it is going to be a 1 year, 2 year or 3 year or maybe more than that. It's been 6 years I am associated with my organization. So, it depends. So definitely you should read about the company profile. You should think what kind of problem this organization must be facing and how can I help them? What is the stability period you are able to see with this organization? What they can give you? Is there any space for the creativity? So these things you'll be able to understand once you are going through their profile. You're going through some of the employees' comment which they post on Glassdoor. So these are some of the things you should definitely do before you are actually going, for an interview or you are going to meet any recruiter for some specific role. And do search about it. So in case you know the recruiter name, in case you know the person whom you will be meeting in the organization, just go through the LinkedIn profile, understand what this person is, what kind of,
Hello, Ms. Shweta.
Am I audible? Sorry. Sure. Okay. Sure. All right. Thank you. So, So do not, forget to search about the person you will be meeting to. It is very important. Just go through their LinkedIn profile and that will give you everything. I don't know how much of you have checked my LinkedIn profile before coming to this session, because that is also important. So a person who is talking to you should have some competency, skills, and you feel more confident. You know that, what background this person is coming from and what kind of thought process this person can bring in. So if you have not started doing that, I think this is the right time for you to start, doing this practice for everything. Whatever you do, wherever you go, whomsoever you are meeting from the business perspective, you should definitely try to know more about that person. You want me to take a pause here in case you guys have any questions? Or shall we begin? Move forward? All right. Okay, I think I have to reshare my screen. I don't know, something is wrong. And that is what is troubling all of us. I'm really sorry about it.
It's fine. We can see you properly.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. All right. Thank you. Okay. So let's talk about, the next step. So how we have to proceed further. We have already talked about pre-hiring and now post-hiring. So what exactly happens? So you are now selected for an interview. You reach to the meeting room again early. Why early? Because you have to make it. So this is not for anybody else. Even if you are coming for a training program, ensure that you are reaching at least 10 minutes early. It is nothing to do with your impression. It is nothing to do with anybody, but it is related to you because you want to feel comfortable. You want to feel confident. So think from that perspective. Try to reach early in the meeting room. Think what you can highlight about yourself. And these are some of the things which you really have to think before you are going to a meeting room, or maybe a day before, or maybe 2 days before. Maybe in your first introduction with your team, what kind of things you want to highlight, which they can remember about you. And that is how you bring, some value into the team, because this is something through which they will always remember you. Do not forget again, because in corporate world, only diary pen and laptop is your best friend. Let me tell you that. Because if you don't have a diary, you don't have a pen, you don't have a laptop, I don't know. I mean, how you will lead the conversations, how you will plan, and it becomes very difficult for a professional, people. So take notes of everything. This is, you know, once you are reaching to the campus post hiring. So just, you know, take note of everything. Whenever there is work which has been given to you, just try, take a note of that. Ensure that you are closing all the things which are there in your diary or notes on your laptop. So this is how, you can. So our target is to gain trust of our leaders. And this is how you will start gaining the trust. In case you are missing a lot of things, you don't have anything, you are just listening in the meeting and then you are ending up, okay, mujhe kya karna hai? So that is something which will create a negative impact on your leadership and you will end up doing nothing. I mean, it just the see, negative impression can be created in friction of seconds, but it takes a lot of effort to create that kind of, positive impact. So hence, you start preparing from the first day. In fact, before that, even today also, if you're going to your classroom, you're coming to some training session, always remember that you have to take some notes because you're spending your time. There has to be some key takeaways, on which you should be working post the session. So, and definitely preparation is the key. If you are prepared for something, nobody can beat you. You will always, get the success no matter wherever you are. And I just want to share a quick scenario with all of you. What happens whenever we have new joinees in our organization? The first question I get from them is, we feel shy. And this I'm talking about when I actually started my professional career and when we used to get batches of the management trainees, this was the major problem. In fact, if I talk about in today's scenario, people and the professionals who are coming, they're pretty open, they don't hesitate. But if I talk about that time when I joined the organization, and I'm talking about I have 11 years of experience, and please do not guess my age because of this. So we used to have that kind of hesitation, and this is something which I also felt, and it took me a lot of years to come out from this, problem. I know there is a meeting happening. I know I have certain kind of questions in my mind, but I will not ask them. I will definitely not ask them. Why? Because I'm thinking that, maybe I may sound like a fool. People think that I'm stupid, or maybe, they can think 100 things about me. But that is not something which matters. What matters is how you want to portray yourself, how you want to take things forward, how you want to close things. And if you're not asking questions, let me tell you, you will end up doing nothing, because sometimes it happens, and it happens in fact today also. So there is a meeting which has started and they're just talking, two people are just keep on talking, but we have to close this, we have to close that. And I'm the person who has joined that meeting for the first time and I have no clue what are they talking about. So because I am hesitant and I don't want to ask question, I'll keep on listening to them and they'll just end up the call. And next day I'll get the, minutes of meeting that Shweta has to close da, 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 da. And I'll be like, okay, aise karna kaise hai? So instead of getting into that situation, you better ask them, excuse me, can you please set the context? Can you please tell me what is this all about? I'm sorry, this is my first meeting. This is my first connect with all of you. Will you mind telling me about, some of the basic things? Will you mind if I ask a couple of questions and then start building the conversation, and this is how you will get to know that what exactly is expected out of you. And sometime it happens, your leaders, your teachers for that matter, giving you a lot of things to do. Acha ye kar lena, wo kar lena, just close this, just close that. And you don't know the context. So how can, you imagine that you'll be putting your 100% efforts in that till the time you're not asking question. So just ask madam or sir or maybe boss, what is the context behind it? What is the outcome? What do you want me to achieve? So these three questions, if you'll ask, definitely you'll be in a safe zone. People will start trusting you because they know that you are trying to understand things and you really want to work. So that kind of impression you will bring, So with this, let's move to the tool number 5, which I call ABC of professional etiquettes. And here I'll be seeking your participation so that I'll also be assured that all of you are listening to me. So ABC of professional etiquettes is nothing much. It is very easy. We are using it on a daily basis. So first is definitely the appearance. How do we look and our behavior in the corporate environment? You know, how we are behaving, how we are reacting on certain things, that gets measured, and that is how, you know, we built a environment around us. So that is something which we really have to think before we do. So let's say, for example, sometime you get some work which you are not supposed to do, right? So in that situation, how you tackle that situation, how you you know, ensure that your managers are aware about it, you know, so those kind of things which you can follow. And then of course the communication. Now let's you know, quickly, and I know that it's already 4 o'clock, and I will not take much of your time because we have to close the session on time, but since we started late, I might stretch by you know, 10 minutes if that is okay with all of you.
You can take your own time.
Sure. Thank you. Such a relief. Thank you so much. So quickly, you know, let's do an interactive activity here. You are able to see a picture on the screen at your right hand side. Now tell me, what do you think? What do you think about this lady? What is the first, because of maybe her appearance or maybe wherever she's sitting, maybe because of that, you have some first thought, you know, in your mind. So can somebody would like to take the lead here? Quickly, please.
Yes, yes. Like a relief, a sort
okay.
of.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
She's looking very happy.
Okay. And can you guess something about her profession? Anything? Any guesses? The first thought which has come to your mind, or maybe imagine you are the interviewer and she's coming to you. What is the first thought you are getting? Any answers? Or shall I start taking out the names from the list as your class teacher do with all of you? I can do that. Khushbu, are you there? Khushbu, can you hear me? Okay. Anyone else want to answer this question? This is a very simple question. Come on. If there is no interaction, it becomes difficult for a trainer to. Yeah.
From
Virendra.
Confidence of her face, she's looking from HR.
She's looking from HR, okay, because of the confidence. Okay. Thank you, Virendra. Okay, anyone else? Rashika, would you like to answer this? Though you are my co-host, but still. Okay, anyone else who would like to take this? Shweta can answer. Shweta P, are you there? Can you hear me? Okay, all right. Anyone who wants to take the lead and talk about it so that I can proceed further? Vijay, would you like to take the lead? Or maybe Vigneshwari?
Sorry, my internet just went off. Can you please?
Okay, so there's a lady, you know, I'm just showcasing a picture on a screen.
Hello.
So there's a... Hey, hi. Hi, who's this?
Hello.
Hi, you want to say something?
I think this is not much of a professional picture, so I can't...
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hello.
Okay.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you loud and clear.
Yeah.
Tell me.
So, mm-hmm. I can't guess a profession because this is not a professional picture, first of all.
Okay.
And the second thing, she's chilling somewhere apart from her professional life. This is a personal life, what I can guess.
Okay, and anything which is coming into your mind, because she looks like this, so maybe her profession could be this. Any guesses? You don't have to be correct, it's okay, but any guesses around it?
Maybe she's a budding model, you can say.
Okay, superb, Kanishka, thank you. All right, I think I was talking to Kanishka only.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you, Kanishka. Anyone else?
So it looks like she may be a budding model. This can be a professional picture. This can be one.
Sure. Very nice. Very good. Thank you, Kanishka. Let's move on to someone else now. Virinder has answered. Kanishka has answered. Anyone else who wants to take the lead and talk about it? Arushi, what about you? Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, I also think that either it might be a personal photo or otherwise it could be that she sent it across as a professional photo. In that case, it would be she's applying for being a model.
Okay, sure. All right. Good guesses. Okay, so let's move on and let's reveal the story. Let's see. And the message I want to share with all of you is, appearance, this is how our appearance plays a very, very important role, because this lady is sitting on a stool, a bench, maybe somewhere near the beach, and she's wearing a jeans, we just thought, the first thought came into our mind, maybe she's a model, or maybe she's on some outing, she's not professional, or maybe she's a HR because she looks very confident. So these kind of thought processes started coming into our mind, though we are not her interviewer, we are not somebody who is linked with her, but we still thought a lot of things about just because of her appearance. And now let's begin, let's move. And again, it is showing me that it's not ready to move on. Okay. Sure. So she's the one. She is Arunima Sinha. She is Indian mountain climber. She is a sportswoman, and she is disabled. She doesn't have her, one leg, and that is what she do. But if you look here, the first appearance, you will think that this lady may be a model, maybe a HR, but she doesn't have to do anything with that. She is absolutely, a mountaineer, a person who is from the sports industry, and she has her name. She is actually representing India everywhere, and this is how it is. Now you understand with this small example how your looks play a very, very important role. So once you are coming for an interview and you are wearing a jeans, no matter what, but the first unconscious biasness, we call it, so that unconscious biasness will take the place, will take your 10 numbers from your overall score. This is what will happen with the interviewer, no matter what. Even if interviewer is very jazzy and interviewer is very open-minded, very cool, doesn't matter, but your first appearance will definitely give you plus 10 or take plus 10, from your kitty. So that is why I say that appearance is very, very important. Behavior, how you're behaving, is again important. And all of you know when I'm talking about behavior, what does it mean? And communication, as I mentioned, it's definitely cherry on the cake. So it will always help you to communicate better, to gel up with people better, and people will start, looking up to you. Now, personal branding is something which is required for everyone, and this in this corporate area, in this corporate era, where we are struggling on almost every day and struggling with our own self, because we want to look good, we want to do certain things which can give us some limelight, so we need to do personal branding with some kind of strategy. Personal branding can't be that you are asking 100 questions in a forum and you don't know about the industry, and then you are trying to get the limelight. That will not give you any limelight, let me tell you. That will give you all negative things. People will talk about you. People will think that You are just trying to be over smart, and there is nothing which they can look up to you. So whenever you talk, and when you really want to brand yourself, you use this framework. So first thing is important, what people want most. So this analysis, all of you have to do, and do share your analysis with me. You can post your analysis on the LinkedIn. You can share with me, you can ping me, and I'll be happy to see that how you guys are moving forward post attending this session. And that becomes my ROI, my ROI to guess that how much you have learned. So revenue on the investment which I'm making. So I'm making one and a half hour investment, but revenue I will get only in terms of once you'll start implementing at least one concept which I'm sharing with you, that becomes my revenue. And similarly, revenue becomes for you because you are investing your time in this session. If you are able to work on certain things which I'm sharing, that becomes your revenue. So this is how we have to work with each other. Now, personal branding is about is all about standing out from the crowd. So how do you do it? Now, whenever you get time, take a piece of paper, think these things, what people want most. Just, maybe do some market research as per your industry in which you are working. Understand from your leaders, what do you want most? What are your problem areas? And then what you can do best. You have to note down that also. What I am best at. Then what your competitors struggle with. So maybe your leader is struggling with, maybe he wants to plan a training session and you are good at public speaking. And, maybe this is what they are looking for. And then your self-discovery will start. So once you'll do this exercise, whatever comes here in the middle of these circles, that becomes your competitive advantage, that becomes your area of confidence, and that is something which you have to explore in yourself. So do this exercise, post me your comments, your sheets, worksheets on my LinkedIn. You can ping me also, do that, and then maybe if time permits, if situation permits, we will do one more exercise and we will go into a deep dive into personal branding. But if you are using this tool of personal branding, let me tell you some of the benefits. One, you stay out of the crowd, you stand out of the crowd, you get that kind of limelight which all of you deserves. Your leaders will start talking about you, start thinking about you, start giving you some more work because you have that kind of personal branding. It's very easy to do something and leave it. Do something, leave it. Do something, complete it, and then publish it. Then tell your organization that, hey, I have done this. This is the impact. This is the ROI. This is the change I'm able to bring. That is called the self-branding. That is called, you are able to showcase what you're doing. And this talent, this, competency, this skill doesn't come without practice. So you have to practice a lot. You have to apply these, frameworks when you are performing any job, no matter where, in your campus, in your corporate life. But this is something which needs to be followed. So we'll do a follow-up session maybe on this if everything permits us, but definitely I would like to see this sheet which you are able to see in front of you. You may note it down, or I will share the PPT with all of you. What people want most, understand from your industry, what do you best at? So what is there which you can do best? What your competitors struggle with? That is also something which you have to figure out, and then create a chart, and whatever comes into the middle circle, that becomes your competitive advantage. And that is something which you have to grow. And let me also tell you, as I have mentioned in my presentation, if you want to be known for everything, you will be known for nothing. You will be known for nothing. So if you're targeting 200 things in one go, nothing. You'll get just nothing. Just understand what are your capabilities, how you want to achieve them, what are the three things you do best. There may be 100,000 things, but there must be two or three things which you do at your best. And that is something which you have to develop, which all of us has to develop. That becomes your, the competitive advantage, your self-discovery. And again, nothing changes with this also, because again, my system is saying that, it's not ready to showcase the next slide. I am really sorry about it, but please bear with me for this. Okay. Now I think situation has become even more complicated. Okay. From the organization perspective, actually, we have moved to Teams now. After that incident, I'm sure all of you must be aware what happened with the Zoom thing. So maybe that is the reason I'm facing this issue. And I'm sorry, I'm not able to showcase the further slide, but I can definitely talk about it. It's just in front of me, so I'll definitely, you know, read for you. So now, you know, let's move on to the personal risk management framework. So what is personal risk, you know? Once you will reach to the organization, once you'll go to the organization, one thing you will easily hear from them is the enterprise risk management. But this is personal risk management. This terminology, somewhere, you know, I found when I was going through a lot of risk and there was no management which was done by me. So this is how I thought when I got invitation of this particular session. I thought, you know, what best I can tell you in this session. And then I thought, let's talk about personal risk management framework as to how you can mitigate your risk which you will be facing in the corporate world. So multiple skills, multiple roles, multiple projects will scare you all the time. Whenever you will reach to a corporate environment, they will hire you as a HR, but they want you to process the payroll. And if you remember, when Ricky was giving my introduction, she said that I have taken care of the payroll in the education industry, and then there was a lot of things, and then I mentioned that I'm from the generalist background, you know, not journalist, it's generalist background in HR, which means a person who is competent to do multiple things, you know, which comes into the HR role. Of course, do not make yourself scared because you are playing multiple roles in an organization, or you have got multiple projects, or maybe you have got multiple skills. Let me tell you, just in the beginning of your professional career, give yourself at least 2 to 3 years where you do not ask yourself what work you are doing. Just do it. Whatever comes to you, just try, do it. But do not do it in case you feel that, you know, you are just, it's just a tick in the box kind of thing for you. If you're not able to do the deep dive into the subject, you're not able to learn anything out of that thing, that is something which is not giving you that much of excitement, then my suggestion would be do not do it. But if you feel that you really want to grow into this particular field and you're getting multiple kind of roles, multiple kind of projects, multiple kind of, you know, work on your desk, do not hesitate to take it, understand, you know, understand, do a deep dive into the subject, and that will give you the overall, when you'll see yourself after maybe 10 years, 5 years, 6 years, you will find that, wow, what kind of roles I have played so far. It's exciting. So if somebody can, you know, if I'm into a discussion and one of my friend belongs to a payroll team, I can have a discussion with him easily because I have processed payroll. And then, you know, if there is a person who is from other stream in HR, maybe performance management, I have not done performance management, so I may not talk about it, right? But if I'm learning performance management also, if I'm learning, you know, multiple things, multiple projects, if I'm handling, so it gives me flavor. It gives me different kind of flavors, and these flavors will eventually add up to my overall experience, my overall industry knowledge. And hence, I always say that it's okay. Whatever work you are getting from your managers, you're getting from your leaders, understand the concept, understand the outcome, and then do it. And then you will realize that you have not done this work just because of sake, maybe, you know, just because you want to do it, or maybe your manager is saying. It is more from the understanding perspective. It is more from the adding value in your resume. So just do it with that thought process, and you will definitely find a you know, difference. So capability and skills, which is the another you know, point, helps you a lot because it mitigates your risk. Definitely, if you have capability and you have skills and you have a problem, you know, it becomes very easy. Even if you don't have capability, you don't have skill, but you have a problem. You develop your skills, you develop your capability. It's very easy. So what happened? So there is a risk which I'm able to see. Maybe there is a training program in my organization which they want me to organize. Right, but I don't know anything about this industry. Maybe let's take your example, aviation, since they are the sponsor for this particular session. So aviation industry, there is a challenge, you know, and they want me to create a domain session for the aviation industry. I don't know anything about aviation industry. I'm from HR background. So what do I do? Shall I just leave this project because I don't know? Or maybe I mitigate this risk by doing some research around the industry, by maybe meeting people, by maybe meeting leaders, asking them that, okay, this is the problem I'm facing. Can you help me? What do you want me to cover? What is this? Okay. By meeting maybe people who are into that particular role. And this is how you can, enhance your capability, enhance your skill and mitigate the risk. So this is, you know, what can be followed. Family is very, very important, guys. And this is the best time you are spending with your family. No matter what, you all of you are from campus. And in fact, I have my siblings who are, you know, in this campus to corporate transformation journey. I think we just, you know, carry on with a lot of things. We are good with our campus life. We are good with friends. We are good with, what we want to do. We are making ourselves prepared for a journey which is about to begin, which is a corporate industry. One thing we leave behind is our family. So do not do that. You know, this is my personal advice, because they also become your, they also comes into your risk management framework. If your family is with you, you are sharing things with them, they will also help you to mitigate the risk. Maybe your mom, your dad, your sister, brother are not capable to tell you that, okay, this is the corporate problem, this is how you can resolve it. But just because they are with you, you know, they are there for your support. By discussing certain things, you can get a different perspective from them. You know, you can just get a different perspective from them, and maybe whatever you can apply, just take from there and apply it. Take from there and apply it. So this is something which you can do. But family plays a very, very important role. Please include them in your personal risk management framework. Do that so that you feel a little bit connected. You feel that you are in a safe zone when you are planning for your personal risk management. Every risk cannot be, in every risk, you cannot take help from your friends or maybe from your corporate leaders or so on. There is a very, very important role which family plays into your personal risk management. Discuss, ask, seek. You know, these are the things, if you'll do, no problem. You'll face no problem, whatever, situation is there in your corporate life. Technology updates and awareness is important. Look for the technology updates. Be aware what kind of technology is coming into the picture. That will help you. So sometime what happens, whatever you are learning today, maybe you find that, okay, dekh lenge, jab jana hoga corporate mein, maybe we'll think then ki hume kya karna hai. Maybe we'll think, we'll start preparing then. But you never know. These learning dots, then they will connect, how they will connect. You know, you never know. So hence, I always say that please be aware. Whatever you are doing, if you are doing it, do it with 100% awareness. It's not, if you're ticking in the box for certain things, let's say, for example, if you're attending this session, but you're not listening, you're just, doing 100 other things, then you are not even ticking in the box. You know, you're just lying to yourself. You're just lying to the outer world that, hey, I'm there, but you're not there, but you're missing a lot of things. Tomorrow, once you will reach to a corporate environment, when you will face these challenges there, you will never be able to recall that, hey, mujhe to ye sare tips already pata the. You know, maybe I have gone through that session where I was on mute and maybe I was just doing my dishes in the kitchen, or maybe I was just mopping the floor, or maybe I was just, watching TV, Netflix, but you will struggle in your corporate environment, and you have all the tips in your hands today, but you will not pay attention. Then you will struggle. Then you will find out on Google, you will find this presentation, and then you will start applying all those tools which I'm talking about. But what if you are aware today, if you are aware today, then automatically you will plan your next steps. You know, instead of watching Netflix, you will be more attentive towards the session, and you know, you will be just sure that acha theek hai ye 10 tool diye hain, is 10 tool mein se I just want to follow these two tools. I want to start in during the pandemic. Uske baad to bahut difficult hone wala hai, so at least ye do tool aaj main utha ke I just want to begin with it. And then you know, this during this pandemic time, our physical mental health is also struggling. You know, all of us are struggling. We are not able to meet our friends. Abhi thoda sa better ho gaya, but if I talk about like 4-5 months down the line, it was very, very difficult. But you keep your physical mental health you know, good, in a good shape, so that you can think, ideas can come to you. If you have any problem, just discuss, use your family you know, to discuss those things, use your personal risk management framework, use your friends, just talk about those problems instead of just, you know, continuing with those kind of issues which you must be facing during your campus, during your corporate life. And definitely once you are going from campus to corporate, you try to find similar things which you do in campus, which is not acceptable by the you know, corporate industry. So you have to maintain healthy relationships and professional relationships with people. That is something very, very important. So if you are into a corporate environment, please do not carry a lot of baggage from your campus. You know, just think that these people who belongs to the corporate industry, they are very, very professional. They are very, very professional, let me tell you. I'm just reiterating for all of you, because I can understand your heart, you know, your soft hearts. When you're in campus, there is always a bhai chara, but in professional life, there is no bhai chara. There is no bhai chara. So that is something which you have to think about, and keep your bhaichara in the campus, keep your friends in the campus, talk to them, discuss about your professional problems with them, but always maintain a healthy relationship, professional relationships in the workplace, for sure. And entertainment is definitely, once the cinema halls are open, you can book your tickets through Book My Show and you can definitely enjoy the way you were. I think this is just the pandemic situation, and because of which we all of us are stuck, else everything was good. And you know, we all of us will be back on the track. I think I'm just on the almost on the last slide, but again, this Zoom is not happy with me, I'm sure. Okay, great, it is okay, it is happy now. So where should I start? Instead of putting thank you, bye bye, okay, tata, I thought, you know, I'll give you where should I start. So what exactly, what is the crux of this complete session which I talked about? So first step which you have to take today, just think about it, you know, just do not let it go. Do not let it go, because I'll be calculating my ROI, you know, on your each step, and you are going to keep me updated on your each step. So first thing, you please enroll yourself for one training program at least. Go to Coursera, go to Udemy, go to LinkedIn. They are offering lot of free courses. Please note down, in case you have a pen and a paper, who are your best friends, but in case you don't have your best friend around, I will share this slide with the you know, with the team, and they will forward it to you. So Coursera, Udemy and LinkedIn. So please do a promise to yourself that you will be enrolling yourself for one program on Coursera, Udemy, LinkedIn, according to the industry you are targeting for, and you will keep me posted on your you know, development as to how you are completing these courses, how it is going. Learn about industry and their trends. Just understand how industry work, what kind of trends are there, how aviation industry for that matter is working right now, you know, and there's a major dip, and how you know, they are thinking to bring this particular industry on track. What kind of things are happening, you know, outside of our comfort zone. And socialize professionally, you know, understand others' role. So once you are reaching to a corporate, or maybe you are in campus, just try and understand what other people do, because that will give you you know, a bigger thought process that will help you to understand what kind of roles they are playing and how that role is actually connected with your work. So that will give you a big picture of your organization, and definitely seek help. Please seek help. There is no problem. Ask questions as many you can. Seeking help is the best thing. So in fact, when I was preparing this presentation, I can't tell you how much help I seek from my mentors, from my seniors. I connected with them. I asked them that, okay, tell me, you work on daily basis with people who are coming straight away from the college. What kind of challenges you face? What do you want me to talk about in this session? No matter how much I know, no matter, you know, how much they know, it is about collaboration. It is about what they can bring in, what I can insert, and then, you know, what we can deliver it to you, right? And how can you utilize that? That again, depends on all of you. So seek help always wherever you are stuck. Ask questions. You know, just understand what's in it for me, right? Update your profile, please update your profile on LinkedIn, guys, if you have not started it. You know, suddenly once you'll go to the corporate industry, you will start updating your profiles, and then you will end up doing nothing but just updating your profile, and then a lot of your work will go you know, pending, and then you will think about 100 ideas then. But I think this is the right time for you to start with it. Update your profile regularly, update your LinkedIn profile regularly, not the Facebook profile, LinkedIn profile. What kind of things you can bring in on your LinkedIn profile? What is happening? What is Harvard Business Review for them who are from HR background? What is happening in the aviation industry? How many people are, you know, giving their private jets for that matter, you know, as a charter plane? So these are some of the things which are happening in the industry. And most of us doesn't even know about it. You know, there are a lot of private jets who are now becoming a private charter flight for a lot of people who really want to join the oil and gas field. So those kind of things are happening, and this is very, very you know, unusual. We haven't seen this kind of thing in past. In fact, this kind of pandemic, because of this pandemic, how many changes are coming from the technology perspective, industry perspective. Just understand all of that. Post your content which is relevant on LinkedIn. Please do not get into any kind of conversation where you know, people are able to see what is your behavior. You know, what is your social behavior is important. You know, how you are tackling people socially is important, but do not bring your campus fights on the LinkedIn. And there are certain examples, and hence I thought I'll share with all of you. So do not bring your campus fight on your LinkedIn group, because let me tell you, everything on the LinkedIn is being tracked by the recruiters. We are able to see, professionals are able to see. So please do not do that. Just treat your LinkedIn profile as absolutely professional profile of you. And last but not least, be curious, because I feel curiosity is the beginning of wisdom. So if you're not curious to learn something, you are, you know, you will never be able to reach wherever you want to reach. So curiosity is very, very important. Just be curious, try, understand, learn about new things on daily basis, and ask your question to yourself that what new you have learned today. And do keep me posted about your journey on Coursera, Udemy, LinkedIn. I will take a pause here because my slides are over, and I will hear, you know, I'll be happy to hear your questions in case you have any. Over to you, team.
I want to ask one question. Sure. I want to ask two questions. I don't want one.
Sure.
I want one thing from you, as you have already covered a very good point. But I think that according to my perspective, that what I have faced in the corporate sector, as I work with many MNCs, and I faced one issue, and that they never tell in the induction program, they never tell during the time, during the training, that what is the grievance procedure. If you are new in the company, and if you are facing any issue with your manager, if you're facing any issue with CEO or anything, if you're facing issue with HR, I want that why they don't tell that, how to handle that, what is the right procedure to file a grievance, right? Okay. There are very rights, there are human rights, there are employees' rights that says that to your supervisor, there are 24 hours to file, to respond in your complaint. I want that, I want this thing from you on this platform, that please tell to the interns, that tell to our future managers, that how they are going to handle this thing in the future. If they are facing some problem, then where they can file their complaints, their grievance, and what is the right procedure that if I think that if you're aware about the laws as you have worked in different companies, so how this laws can help us. And as you talk about mental peace, right? Mental peace is a biggest crime in the organization. If you are not mental, you are not in peace, you are not mentally fine in your organization, then you can directly file a complaint. But we are not aware about this fact. Our interns, we are the new trainee, we are not aware about the fact that yes, if I'm not in mental peace, I can file a complaint. So I just want that, please focus on this for a few minutes more.
So I will just break down your question into two parts. First is the grievance and another is the mental peace. So mental peace, I would like to begin with. So mental peace is nothing but your mental ability. When you think that you are not able to tackle this issue, and when you think that this issue is creating a lot of challenges, which is hampering your thought process, which is hampering you mentally. And then, you know, grievance is something when you are not able to tackle with this mental situation. And then you, think and you reach to the conclusion that this is now an ongoing problem, and hence this becomes my grievance. So this is, you know, how it generally works. So now grievance in the corporate industry, we have to address these grievances, we follow the hierarchy procedure. So in case I have any problem with my manager, I go ahead, talk to her one-on-one, talk to him one-on-one. I just tell that, you know, these are the problems I'm facing and how can you support me on this particular area. If I feel that my manager is somehow not able to help me, she or he is, you know, maybe... and this is what leads to the mental stress. You know, maybe we are just getting enough of work and manager is not paying attention. And, you know, there are a lot of challenges which we have at the managerial level. Then there is a hierarchy where we go to the secondary level of, manager, where we discuss about our grievances. Now, I really want to, and this can be a complete session. Grievance handling or reporting grievance is an art. You know, sometimes which maybe you are considering as grievance is nothing, because you are understanding it from your own perspective. You are able to see 100 kind of problems there. But one day when you will decide that, okay, this is enough. There is a lot of work I'm getting. I'm not getting recognition. I'm not getting enough pay. What do I do? So on that day, if you're making this, conscious decision to sit with your manager to talk about the challenges, just note down those challenges, talk about your challenges with your manager, tell her or tell him that, boss, I am facing this problem. Now you help me understanding how do I proceed further. That is the time you will see that there is no grievance. In fact, manager will tell you 100 things ki, yaar, I'm sorry, maine tumko ye de diya, mujhe khud nahi pata tha iska basics. So again, once you will start asking questions, right questions, once you will start seeking clarity. Or corporate environment mein kya hota hai, Ricky, just to answer your question, corporate environment mein we work in silo. Though we are a centralized organization, but we work in silo. Andar hi andar hum log apna kaam karte hain, but we have lot of, you know, troubles around which we don't want to talk about. Right?
To know our interns that your mental peace is your right in the organization. If you feel that you're not feeling comfortable, if you're facing any issue, then you definitely can talk to your manager. There is a legal procedure, you can read about it, and you should know what is your right as an employee. You never get nervous that I'm a new employee, I can't file complaint, what other people say. No, never. You should be very much free, and you should focus on the point that she mentioned. And the next important thing that you have focused, and I'm very much happy that you focused that point, and you focused on family points. I'm very much happy because you are the first person till date that talked about this thing in the corporate sector. Because whenever I worked in the corporate sector, I remember that the CEO or the great managers, they used to come in our... first meeting, first session, and they always tell one thing, that they always say this thing in a very proud manner, that I never take leave. I always take leave once in a year. Mm-hmm. So I mean, oh, actually, why are you doing this thing? You're not balancing your life with your work. So it's a great point that you have mentioned, and I'm really thankful to you.
I'm glad.
And at the end of the session, I would like to invite Ms. Navneet Kaur, who is a manager of public relations and advertisement, for the vote of thanks. Thank you so much.
Okay, so lastly, we'd like to express our sincere thanks to you. We are very grateful to you for analyzing this topic of campus to corporate. And we are also like to acknowledge our gratitude to you, Ms. Shweta. Immensely inspired by your precious words. Once again, a very thank you from our side. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for having me here. Thank you. It was wonderful connecting with all of you. Thank you for being such a wonderful audience. And as I said in my session, that I look forward to hear from each one of you on your development, how you are taking the steps which I shared with all of you forward. That is something which will excite me. And that is something, you know, which will help me to understand the ROI. Yes, there is a question I can see in the window. Okay, so... Okay, what's the question?
Mr. Devinder, I think he wants to ask some questions.
Devinder, please go ahead.
Mr. Devinder Kumar, do you have any question? Okay. Ma'am, in case of campus